Hi folks, I'm Expanded Universe and welcome to MAD, a show where I go through the entire HAL as best I know the Expanded Universe. I think I'm having a stroke. Alright folks, today we're going to go to Star Wars 12, number 8, written by Henry Gilroy. Now these are actually a collection of reprints from the Star Wars Kids magazines, issues 16 through 20. Now in this series, after they're wrapping up the evacuation of Hoth, Leia, 3PO, and Han travel to the Death Star debris, I guess just to kick around there, but they're hijacked by space pirates. Oh no! That were hiding in the debris, hence Death Star pirates. But Luke comes to their rescue, and then they all get back and they all start heading back on their way to evacuating Hoth. So this is in the middle of that craziness where they're running back and forth trying to make sure everyone's making it safe there. They just threw this little adventure in there, and boy did they squeeze it in, because this is a jam-packed little spot, this evacuation of Hoth thing. Seems like everyone wanted to get in on this story. Now from there, I'm going to take you from Star Wars Tales, and I'm going to move you back into the Marvel comic books. And so the first issue we're going to talk about is number 17, where Hans Falcon fails to make it to Hoth, and Luke is getting worried. Now, Leia's already back, so obviously she made it back, but maybe on one of these runs back and forth, I don't know, Han and Chewie are lost. And this may be the last transport out, and they're like, Where's Han? I thought he was with you. And so Luke has to go look for him. And so Luke goes to this planet where he thinks he tracks down the Millennium Falcon, and he finds Tanis Shire. What? What's she doing here? Bum, bum, bum. Well, you have to find out. And then that's where we lead into issue 18, where Luke not only encounters her, but he encounters the Night Beast again from a previous comic book. And then he encounters Obi-Wan Kenobi. What is going on? This is crazy. What are all these people here doing on this planet? Oh, wait a minute. Luke has been in the clutches of an evil mind witch. Sybil is her name. And this mind witch has been, giving him hallucinations, and that's why he's been encountering all these things. Now, what was real and what wasn't, we'll never know. And Luke will never know, but he has to escape the mind witch, and so that he, Luke, and Han can make it safe off the planet and make it back to Leia on Hoth, where Leia can go, shame on you boys for goofing off. And she sends them on the next mission. And so everyone is happy. Hooray! Let's talk about mind witches, shall we? Yes, it's time for that talk. There is a lot of magical, mythical people in the expanded universe, and especially in the Marvel universe, like a mind witch. Is she basically one of the witches of Dothamir in a way? In a way, she could be. There are different people in the universe who use the Force, but they use it different ways and they're called different things. Sorceresses, we have sorcerers, we have wizards. We have several titles for all these people who can use the Force, but basically, just keep in mind, it's the Force they're using. I mean, yeah, a mind witch, she creates hallucinations. Well, didn't Darth Vader do that to Luke in a few issues before that when he killed Baron Tagg? It was a hallucination. He made Luke think it was Darth Vader. So she just does this on a grander scale. People who have the Force aren't always trained in how they can use it. And people who develop Force powers are not always the same. That's why some people can do this fun thing, like she can do Force projections. That's just one thing she was really good at, so why not? She's a mind witch. Hey, it's a thing. So I didn't really mind that there were this magic element. Remember when it came to Ewoks, they treated it as magic. They called it magic, not the Force. Well, to the Ewoks, it probably is magic, but we all know it as the Force. So again, this doesn't bother me that we have these type of magical, beings in the universe. It makes sense, especially when you're dealing with a galaxy who has the Force. All right, folks, that's all the time I have for now. See you next time with another video.